challenges and new opportunities. I urge all the participants of today's session to engage in constructive dialogue, to jointly identify new points and drivers for growth. I'm sure that our 1+5 format will serve as an important foothold for joining efforts and working out joint agreements for the benefit of our people of our sub-region. Thank you very much for your attention. And now let me give the floor to Under Secretary of State for Foreign Affairs and International Cooperation of Italy, His Excellency Di Stefano. Please, Under Secretary.
Thank you so much, dear colleague, First Deputy Minister Kudratov, members of government, excellencies, distinguished guests. It is an honor for me to co-moderate this session focused on economic cooperation among our countries. First, let me thank First Deputy Minister Lazit Kudratov for his comprehensive opening address and the Uzbek authorities for their hospitality. I would also like to welcome the delegations from Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan, and Turkmenistan for their participation and commitment to strengthen dialogue and cooperation with Italy. Since the first edition of this conference held in Rome in December 2019, Italy has kept on confirming a strong commitment in further deepening partnerships and collaboration with the region. Before the outbreak of the pandemic, I had the chance of paying official visits to all 5 countries, and I was impressed by the economic potential of the whole region. I remember with great pleasure my visits to Tajikistan and Uzbekistan in November 2018, Turkmenistan in March 2019, Kazakhstan and Kyrgyzstan in November 2019. Since our last meeting, we all have gone through difficult times. The pandemic has deeply challenged us. Governments and societies were called to cope with new and unknown problems and to manage an unprecedented situation in international context. Italy was the first in Europe to be strongly hit by the sanitary emergency due to COVID-19. I'm proud to say that we managed it and we overcome one of the darkest moments in our recent history. We have showed to the world our resilience and our strong sense of community. Today in Europe, other countries look at Italy as an example. We are one of the most virtuous countries in the world in managing not only the health emergency, but also its economic consequences, as proved by the significant and constantly ongoing increase of our exports. In the first 8 months of 2021, Italy recorded a +22% in total export, reaching the volume of almost 332 billion euros, an extraordinary result for us. Our companies performed better than in 2019, the golden year for the Italian exporting ecosystem so far. We could achieve such an important outcome also thanks to specific measures in the so-called Pact for Export signed by Minister Di Maio in June 2020, aimed at supporting our small and medium enterprises, the engine of the Italian economy. In this encouraging momentum, we can concentrate our effort on consolidating the recovering trends and keeping our attention high on the sanitary measures we introduced to control the spread of the virus. The European Union, of which Italy is one of the founding members, is today the second economic partner of Central Asia. The EU, with its process of integration, represents the most advanced and successful model of a regional organization. Indeed, thanks to economic cooperation, the EU's member countries started a political process that has guaranteed to the continent a long period of peace, stability, democracy, and rule of law economic growth. In this general framework, Italy looks with increasing attention at the Central Asian region as a strategic area. Our goal is ambitious. We want to do more in Central Asia, strengthening our partnerships by underpinning our political, economic, and cultural presence in the region. It is an ambitious goal because the competition is very fierce, but this is not surprising. Since independence, Central Asian countries succeeded in almost non-stop growth. We have always attached great importance to the cooperation with the region, stepping up our support to the modernization and diversification of the respective economies, sharing experiences, new technologies, and modern solutions. Trade volume between Italy and Central Asia hit its record result, about 4 billion euro in 2018. In 2020, amid the global outbreak of the pandemic, trade volume suffered a significant decrease, and figures in 2021 are still in a recovery phase. The performance in a few sectors was very flattering. Let me mention machineries, metallurgy, electrical equipment, clothing items, computer and other electronic products. Yet, I'm convinced that there is a huge potential for a quality and quantity leap in our trade relations. In pursuing this target, we will continue to follow a regional approach, also through regional visits in the area by our business associations and companies in sectors that the countries of the region share. Indeed, I'm confident that after the global slowdown phase, we can now strengthen our industrial and commercial cooperation, expanding it more significantly to non-oil sectors such as renewables, agro-industry, and advanced industrial machineries for a sustainable economy. The presence here today of the leaders of Italian economic institutions and the fact that most of you have already met them give a concrete evidence of our commitment. For this reason, let me introduce in order of speech the Italian delegation. Carlo Ferro, President of the Italian Trade Agency. Mauro Alfonso, CEO of Simest. Dario Liguti, Chief Underwriting and Business Innovation Officer of SACE. Raffaele Langella, Director of International Affairs of Confindustria. Before leaving the floor to them and to the distinguished representative of the five Central Asian countries, I will cordially invite you to listen to the presentation Italy's Back on Track as a Leading Country for Investment Attractiveness by Luca Miraglia, CEO of the European House Ambrosetti. The European House Ambrosetti is a professional group which provides consulting services, including strategic scenarios and studies to Italian and European institutions and companies. This think tank has already carried out several activities focused on Central Asia, also in collaboration with the Minister of Foreign Affairs. The Italy-Uzbekistan Business Forum is the most remarkable event they organized in cooperation with us last year. Therefore, without hesitation, I invite Mr. Miraglia to take the floor.